We thank you for being in the tabernacle tonight, those that are here. And we thank God for those that will watch it take delay at some other time. But we just thank God for what he's doing here in Lewiston, Woodville. Amen. Thank God for all the doors that he's opening up, the different things of that nature. But tonight I want to, the last time I ministered out of Acts chapter 27. Mm-hmm. And we want to go tonight in that same chapter, if I can, part of it. But let me give you a synopsis of what we discussed. Paul had to go to Rome to see Caesar. And Paul's traveling to Rome, and he tried to warn the people. Because Paul was a godly man. He sought God. He heard from God. And Paul knew in his heart that a storm was going to rage on the sea. But you know, some Christians, but everybody in the world, move by what they see with their natural eyes or what they feel. And they looked up and saw blue sky, a soft wind blowing, which would be good for the sails, for you know, the ship sailed by sail, and they decided to set sail. But a hurricane, if you will, or typhoon came up and a great storm, and they went 14 days with no sun, no stars, no moon, and they didn't know, have no idea where they were in traveling. The storm got so severe that they had to begin to lighten the ship. It was a cargo ship carrying grain, things of that nature, and they had to lower, had to lighten the ship to keep the ship afloat. But Paul praying, this is what the last service was about. Paul praying, and Paul stood up to the men at that particular day. And in verse 23, he says, "For there stood by me this night the angel of God, whose I am and whom I serve." Now, verses, let me read this in the Message Bible, give you an insight. "Last night God's angel stood at my side, an angel of this God I serve, saying to me, 'Don't give up, Paul.'" Amen. You ever felt like giving up? You ever felt like quitting? Ever felt like pulling your hands up and walking away from everything? Well, we all have at some point or another. Amen. And this angel is encouraging Paul on this ship, don't give up. And I'm telling you tonight, do not give up, praise God. I don't care what kind of storm you're in. I don't care what's coming against you. I don't care how many things is falling apart around you. Do not give up, praise God. The angel told Paul, do not give up. You're going to stand before Caesar, yet, and everyone sailing with you also is going to make it. That was the title. You're going to make it. Amen. I'm going to make it, glory to God. We're going to make it, glory to God. Praise God. Paul was in a terrible, terrible storm. And so I'm going to read quite a few scriptures if I can tonight. Because I want you to get the gist of what was happening, okay? In verse, beginning with verse 39, what I just read to you was verses 23 through 26. And we're going to jump over to 39. And this is, I want to read it from the King James Version. I want you to see what was happening, okay? Remember that they'd gone 14 days, and by the way, there was 276 people on that ship. Now, I got a fishing boat. Fishing-wise, I can carry two people. Boat riding, I probably can carry four people, maximum. But this boat had 276 people. So it was a good-sized boat, or ship, if you will. It wasn't no small fishing boat, if you will. Mm-hmm. And so here we find, we're going to look at verse 39. "And when it was day, they knew not the land, but they discovered a certain creek with a shore into the which they were minded, if it were possible to trust the ship. And when they had taken up the anchors, they committed themselves unto the sea and loosed the rudder bands and hoisted up the mainsail to the wind and made toward shore." Verse 41. "And falling into a place where two seas met, they ran the ship aground and the forepart stuck fast. and remained unmovable, but the hinder part was broken with the violence of the waves. Now, you put yourself on that ship in that storm. The front part of the ship was stuck. It was not moving. The wind's blowing. There's waves, possibly rain. But the hinder part of the ship started breaking apart. I can't swim. Even as much times I go fishing and things of that nature, I cannot swim. I never learned it. And so I can imagine what fear may have come upon me being on that ship, and it's breaking apart. I don't know how deep. I know it's shallow water because the ship is underground. Amen.
Yeah.
Many times we go fishing, and we're fishing in sometimes 30 feet of water. The other times we're in 3 foot of water.
Mm-hmm.
But anyway, we find here that the back of that ship was breaking apart with the violence of the waves. And the soldiers' counsel was to kill the prisoners lest any of them should swim out and escape. And that was part of the Roman law, that those that are in charge of prisoners, you but not let them escape, they'll take your life. So that's why this verse says here why they wanted to do that. But the centurion, willing to save Paul, kept them from their purpose and commanded that they which could swim should cast themselves first into the sea and get to land. And the rest, some on boards and some on broken pieces of the ship. And so it came to pass that they escaped all safe to land. If God has put you in a storm,
preach.
Stay in the storm.
Amen.
Because God's got the appropriate time for you to come out of your storm.
Amen.
Amen.
He's got the appropriate time for me to come out of my storm. Everyone in this room tonight, we can testify. It's 10 minutes to 9 here in Lewiston, Woodfield, North Carolina. We can testify from now to 10 minutes to 9 tomorrow morning. Everyone in this room can testify and tell the storms that you've been in your life and how God's got you through those storms, praise God. Amen. And I mentioned the last time about how, you know, in 2020 this virus hit the world, not just America, the world, and millions and millions of people around the world lost their lives because of this virus. And many people was very sick in the hospital and things of that nature. After that, things began to skyrocket. Not just in America, all over the world. The cost of food, the cost of gasoline. Look at the price of it now. Here in Eastern North Carolina, it's over $3 a gallon, pretty much everywhere. But everything skyrocketed, except pay raises.
Lord, it's so true.
So true.
Skyrocketed. But guess what? Back in 2020, for example, when hamburger went on sale for 99 cents a pound, remember them days? On sale, you get it for 99 cents a pound. Now it goes on sale for $3.99 a pound. But guess what? We still have the abilities and the funds to purchase the hamburger at $3.99 a pound or $4.99 a pound, praise God. We've still got food on our tables, praise God. We're still able to put gasoline in our automobiles and come to the house of God, praise God. So what I'm saying is God is still taking care of you and I, glory to God.
Amen.
And he will continue to take care of you and I, praise God.
Amen. Amen.
The angel told Paul, you will still see Caesar, and everyone on this ship's going to make it, praise God. I know it looks rough. The angel didn't know. Look at the situation. It looked rough with the winds and the waves and this, that, and the other. No sun for 14 days and no stars for 14 days. And this angel said, it's going to be okay.
Yes.
But God sent me here to tell you tonight, you that's watching through video, amen. It's going to be okay. God's going to get you through your situation, praise God. He has never failed us, and he never will fail us, glory to God.
Amen.
And many times we have to go through a storm to have a testimony, praise God.
Amen.
Because we want to talk a little bit about a testimony that took place after the storm was over here in Paul's life, praise God. So here we find, beginning with chapter 28, that Paul, they get on this island in an area called Malta. It's about 50 miles south of Sicily in the Mediterranean, a little small island. And there was Barbados people on the island. And they showed us no little kindness. In other words, they showed us a lot of kindness. They were there to help us, to assist us. Amen. The Bible don't say, but it's a possibility because of the rough wind and the waves and things of that nature. Some of them may have got to shore. They got there safely. Excuse me, but they may have scratches on them. I don't know. Possibility. Maybe there was some blood running out of them. No one lost their life. Everybody survived, amen. But the Bible says these people of this island began to assist them and they began to help them. For they kindled a fire and received us every one because of the present rain and because of the cold. They had compassion for them. But these people weren't saved. They didn't know about Jesus Christ. But there was a man, out of 276 people, there was a man by the name of Paul that knew about Jesus Christ. There's a man that by the name of Paul, amen, who persecuted the Christians. There was a man by the name of Paul who was standing there holding the coats of those that stoned Stephen to death, amen, yes. Who got changed on the road to Damascus when his name was changed from Saul to Paul, praise God. Yes. He knew all about Jesus Christ, praise God. This is a golden opportunity for him to witness, praise God. And it's a golden opportunity when you come out of your storm or I'm out of my storm to witness and tell what God did, amen. How God took me out of that situation. How God turned things around, praise God.
Amen.
So here we find as they were building the fire, Paul took a bundle of sticks in verse 3 and laid it on the fire. And there came a viper out of the heat and fastened on his hand. There may be some in the tabernacle, some that's been bitten by. I've never been bitten by a snake, thank the Lord. Never been bitten by a snake. But Paul, amen, can you imagine pulling his hand from them sticks and that snake attached to his hand? The Bible says that he shook it off in the fire.
Amen.
He got rid of it.
Yes, he did.
Now, I'm terrified of a spider. I don't care how little or how big. I'm terrified. I cannot stand spiders. If I see a spider, the spider's not going to live very long. I promise you.
Amen.
I'm going to get rid of it. And I can imagine the Bible. Let's look at what the Bible says. Verse 4. And when the barbarians saw the venomous beast hang on his hand, they said among themselves, look out, this man is a murderer whom thou he has escaped the sea, yet vengeance suffers not to live. And he shook it off the beast into the fire and felt no harm.
Thank you, Jesus.
Amen.
There was something attached to Paul that shouldn't be attached.
Amen.
So Paul shook it off.
Thank you, Jesus.
Amen.
There's many folks in the church today, even Christians, need to shake some stuff off.
Yes.
Preacher.
Need to shake some stuff off. You're having things attached to you that shouldn't be attached to you.
Preacher.
Parasites. Parasite is something that wants to live off you.
Amen.
Come on, man.
Come on. Attach themselves to you. Shake it off. After Paul shook the snake off, the Bible says no harm came to him. God protected him. God stopped the venom, amen, from going into his bloodstream and going to his heart and taking him out of this world, amen. God stopped it, amen.
Amen.
And it gave him the opportunity at that point, amen. And we ain't got time to go through this whole chapter tonight. But it gave him the opportunity to go out and heal people in that little small community and where that ship had wrecked. Amen. It wasn't in God, in Paul's plans to go on this island and minister the way he did. Amen. But it was in God's plan, praise God.
Amen.
It wasn't in Paul's plan to be on a ship. Amen. It wasn't in Paul's plans to go see Caesar, but it wasn't in his plans to be in a storm for 14 days with no sun and no moon and no stars, amen, and the sea, amen. But God sent an angel to him. And God sends angels to you and I, praise God.
Yes, he does.
Amen.
He does, amen. I remember... I don't remember exactly what year it was, around 2007 or 8. My wife and I were traveling from Charlotte area, coming back home. And we were going around the interstate that goes around Raleigh. And the back tire on the vehicle went flat. And I was in the all over about four or five lanes over in the left lane. I had to work my way all the way through that traffic over. In that little bitty car, little small Nissan Sentra is what we were driving at the time, and get over to the side of the road. We got over to the side of the road, I got out of the car, I took the luggage out of the trunk, amen. I got the lug wrench out, and the lug wrench would not work on the tire.
Wow.
But in the process of doing that, a deputy sheriff pulls up behind me and stops. He said, I got a lug wrench and went back to his car and got his lug wrench, which worked, amen. I got the jack out of the car, I put the jack under the car. It was broke, it would not work. I was driving my mama's car, it wasn't my car. He said, I got a jack. He went back, that was my angel.
Amen.
I know it was a human being by the name of John Doe or whatever his name was, amen. He was a deputy sheriff for the sheriff's department in the Durham area, amen. But amen, he was an angel that God sent to me that day, amen, to assist me, to help me get back on the highway. And God's got a way of sending an angel to you, praise God. To take, help you through your situation, help you through your storm, glory to God, amen. And God sent this angel to Paul to encourage him. Don't worry about it, Paul. You're going to make it. You're going to see Caesar. You're going to get there. And not only that, everyone on this ship that don't know Jesus, they're not going to lose their life either. They'll make it also, praise God.
Amen. Yes, Lord.
So God says, we're going to make it. We're going to get to the other side. We're going to get where God wants us to go, praise God.
Yes, Lord.
Amen.
Regardless of the situation, regardless of what your natural eyes see, or watch your natural ears hear. God says, we're going to make it, praise God.
Yes, Lord.
We're going to get there, glory to God. And Paul, amen, what he did, he shook it off. Sometimes we carry too much weight.
Come on, man.
Yes.
Too
yes.
much weight because of what mama said, daddy said, sister said, brother said, cousin said, neighbor said, amen. It begins to attack. We run that stuff through our mind. And first thing you know, we get bogged down.
Amen.
When they were sending rockets into outer space, like the space shuttle, for example, they had to have a certain amount of fuel for that rocket to get off Cape Canaveral. Amen. They had to have a certain amount of payload. They could not overload the shuttle.
Amen.
If they overloaded the shuttle, it would never got off the launch pad. You that have flown in airplanes, or jets, traveling, and things of that nature, myself as well, amen. They'll allow so many people on the plane and so much luggage per person on the plane. Because they realize if they have too much weight, the plane cannot get off the ground. There's not enough thrust behind it, praise God.
Amen.
We are to be free in Jesus, praise
amen.
God.
Yes.
Freer than that jet. Freer than that rocket, praise God. We're to be free. If I'm walking down, burdened down all the time, I don't know what I'm going to do, but somehow I'm going to get through it. What kind of testimony is that?
No.
Come on, saints.
Yes.
We're to be free in Jesus, amen, yes. praise God. I refuse to allow anyone to attach something to me that don't need to be there, praise God. I'm going to shake it off. I'm going to get rid of it, amen. I'm not going to allow it to be in my life, glory to God. I got family members don't like me. That's okay, praise God.
Yes.
I love them. I pray for them, praise God.
Yes.
I got a lot of people, amen, I'm not going to be attached to, amen, if you will. like taking a clip or a paper clip, attach it to you. Amen.
Lord, help us, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Wait. Now, even at my age, even though I don't exercise, actually exercise, I could go out here, and I know I could. I could run from here to the post office. Mm-hmm. Now, I'm not going to run full speed, but I can run from here to the post office. Now, I'm not saying what shape I'll be in when I get there, but I believe I can do it, praise God.
Amen.
But if I put 50 pounds of weight on my back and I start running, I couldn't get here from Martin Luther King Drive.
Amen.
Sure.
Because of the weight, the added weight that's been added to me. So God is saying tonight, amen, shake it off.
Shake it off.
Get rid of it. Amen.
Thank you.
You don't need that kind of mess. I got people that they're no longer friends with me. They chose to separate from me because of my relationship with Jesus. That's fine.
Amen.
But look at all the friends I've picked up since then. Look at all you, praise God. My friend, glory to God.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah, praise God. I picked up good friends, praise God.
Yes, sir.
Hallelujah. Friends that's going to back me up. Friends that are going to stick with me, glory to God.
Amen.
Paul, the storm had ended. And then came the opportunity for Paul to witness to these people on this island.
Hallelujah.
And many people got healed and heard about Jesus Christ. When you come out of your storm, it's time to witness.
Amen. Glory.
When you come out of your situation, it's time to witness.
Jesus.
You can't have a testimony without a test.
Yes.
Thank you.
People testify it.
Yes.
Test. We can't have a testimony without a test. And we went through tests.
Yes.
We got people in our tabernacle that are sick. Mm-hmm. We got one individual in the hospital. It's a test. Mm-hmm. It's not only a test for him and his wife, but it's also a test for us. Because they're part of us.
Jesus.
We got others in the tabernacle that they got some sickness going on in their life.
Yes.
But we feel what they feel, amen. Because they're part of us, glory to God. They're part of us, amen. We're concerned, amen. We pray, amen. I called an individual the other day and I said, what can I do besides pray? He said, that's the only thing, pray. 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 We can pray.
Hallelujah.
God, knowing that God answers prayer. Amen. Tonight we gathered up in the front before even starting the service. In a circle we prayed for different individuals. We prayed for situations going on. Amen. In our church we prayed for this and we prayed. We went on and just continued to pray different long. Two of the pastors here were praying. Amen. Waiting for the other pastor to show up. Amen. We saw God. Amen. That's what it's
glory. Glory. Glory.
Praying one for another. Glory to God.
You.
Amen. Now, I may not be able to feel the pain that you're going through, but when you're hurt and I'm hurt, my heart hurts.
Yes.
Amen.
Come on, we hurt.
Yes,
amen.
Lord.
Amen.
Amen. We hurt one for another because, why? Because we love one another.
Yes.
We care about one another.
Amen.
And most important, Jesus loves you and he cares about you, amen. Just as we played before we went online, we played that video, amen. God is here.
Hallelujah.
He is here, praise God.
Thank you.
Hallelujah. He's here. Amen. When you leave this tabernacle, when I get in my car to drive back to Williamson, God will be in the car with me, taking me back to my home, glory to God, praise
amen.
God. And I'll be able to feel his presence in the automobile going down the highway, praise God. When you lay your head on your pillow tonight in your bed, God will be there with you, praise God.
Yes.
All you have to do is call after him and cry out to him, amen. He's there, praise God. When I go to work tomorrow, if by chance I get cussed out, amen, that's all right, amen, because I know God is with me, amen. God is still going to take care of me, glory to God, praise God. And all I do it in the individual, when I do get cussed out over something which is my fault, amen, I just smile at him, praise God.
God loves you.
So that'll tear him up, just smile at him, glory to God. God loves you. Amen.
Yes,
God loves you, praise God.
Yes,
hallelujah.
So the gist of the story, go through your storm. Don't try to end the storm before God wants the storm to end.
Yes,
God's got the appropriate time for that storm to stop.
Amen.
Yeah, we pray, God, take the storm away. Lord, I pray this storm will end. Yeah, we do pray that prayers. Come on, come
yes,
on, come on.
Yes.
But God, in the appropriate time, will end the storm in your life.
Yes.
Where you can give a testimony.
Yes.
I walked in one. This was months and months and months and months ago. I delayed in going to Walmart on a Sunday afternoon. And I walked in going into Walmart, and I normally go in the other entrance. I went into a different entrance at Walmart in Williamson. And an individual walked up to me and said, "You're a preacher, aren't you?" I said, "Yeah," and he started crying. He was in the process of going in Walmart to buy something to end his life. See, he was tired of living. We probably talked 30 to 40 minutes right in front of the entrance to Walmart. I saw that individual last week. He's still living. Got a smile on his face.
Thank you, Jesus.
Amen. Hallelujah.
God's got a way of putting you in the right place at the right time.
Amen.
To help somebody.
Yes, Lord.
Always.
It's based on his timing.
Hallelujah.
I don't need to go into all the particulars of that, of how I wound up at Growing Together Ministry. But based on God's timing, my life service at my church, Pastor David shows up.
Jesus.
And I go to visit that night, just for one time visit. Now it's been one over 3.5 years.
Yes.
I'm still visiting,
thank
praise
you,
God. Praise God. We're still visiting, amen.
Glory.
Walk in God's will. Let God lead you. In Jesus' name.
In Jesus.
God bless you.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Awesome message.
Hallelujah.